Self-flying planes sound like something from a distant sci-fi future. After all, we don't even have reliable self-driving cars yet. But what if I told you that autonomous planes are already here? Well, sort of. Just take a look at the Cessna Grand Caravan, which can take off, fly at cruising altitude, and land on the runway without a single person on board. The aircraft is instead controlled and monitored by a remote control center on the ground. Of course, small cargo aircraft with self-flying software have only been certified for test flights in segregated airspace, but nonetheless, this marks a pretty exciting milestone in our nearly century-long quest for autonomous flight. So how soon can we see large passenger jets fly by themselves? In order to understand the future of autonomous flight, we need to first understand how it all began. You see, back in the 1950s, the FAA required commercial aircraft to have 5 people in the cockpit: a pilot, co-pilot, flight engineer, radio operator, and navigator. But over the decades, that number gradually went down to just 2. Thanks to the advent of aircraft like the A320, which featured newer fly-by-wire systems. Here, instead of pilots manually controlling the aircraft, their inputs are processed into electronic signals that are then interpreted by flight computers to maneuver the aircraft. Thanks to fly-by-wire, we now have much more advanced autopilot, where these flight computers can be instructed to fly the plane pretty much on their own. That's why it's estimated that the average Boeing pilot spends only about 7 minutes manually steering the aircraft, and that number is even lower for Airbus pilots. Of course, this doesn't mean pilots just sit back and let autopilot do all the work. Pilots have to instruct autopilot exactly how to do its job. For instance, pilots can choose one of 7 possible climbs or descents depending on the situation. Today, autopilot can perform 5 of the 6 main phases of flight on its own: cruise, climb, descent, approach, and landing. However, auto land is rarely used, since setting it up takes forever, but under poor weather conditions and low visibility, auto land can actually outperform human pilots. So modern autopilot can do pretty much everything except taxiing and takeoff, but even that could be about to change pretty soon. Both Boeing and Airbus have already successfully demonstrated fully autonomous takeoffs, and just this last summer at the Farnborough Airshow, Embraer announced the world's first ever commercial automated takeoff system, set to debut in its E2 family as early as next year. The Embraer Enhanced Takeoff System, or E2TS for short, is capable of taking off entirely on its own using data from 3 computers and 4 smart probes. Essentially, how it works is that a computer figures out the most efficient way to lift the plane's nose off the ground. Or in other words, it saves fuel by getting the plane into the air as fast as possible. But what's the point of having an auto takeoff system do this? Can't pilots just take off at steeper angles? You see, for longer aircraft like Embraer's 195 and the A320, simply taking off at a greater angle won't cut it, since that risks a tail strike with the runway. Instead, the aircraft needs to get a few feet above the runway and then rotate, which can be dangerous if not done precisely. Hence the need for E2TS to safely get the plane in the air faster. However, just like with autopilot and auto land, pilots still have to start the auto takeoff, adjust the plane's direction, and even override the system if necessary. Nonetheless, E2TS could become a total game changer, as its efficiency gains would allow aircraft like the E2 and A320 families to fly up to 500 miles farther, unlocking plenty of new routes that would not have otherwise been possible. Or it could lead to more crowded cabins, since you can fly the same distance with more people on board now that you're burning less fuel. And the best part is that since auto takeoff is just a software update, the technology isn't exclusive to Embraers and can be outfitted on other aircraft families as well. So assuming there's no delays, which unfortunately have become the norm in the aviation industry lately, we can see commercial planes take off, cruise, and land on their own by the end of this decade. Which means that pretty soon, ironically enough, taxi could become the only time pilots manually steer the aircraft. While current autopilot is capable of flying the plane under ideal conditions, it can't account for every single thing that could possibly go wrong. But pilotless planes may be coming sooner than we think. Considering that there's a lot less obstacles to navigate in the sky, we could realistically see autonomous aircraft before full self-driving cars hit the road. Right now, the aviation industry is facing a massive pilot shortage that's only expected to get worse in the coming years. This issue is especially prevalent for smaller regional airports and cargo operations. There are currently over 500 parked aircraft because there's simply not enough pilots to fly them. And according to the FAA, about half of current pilots are expected to hit that retirement age of 65 in the next 15 years. So without autonomous planes, it would be pretty difficult, if not impossible, for the aviation industry to keep up with the rapidly growing demand for flying. The good news is that many companies such as X-Wing and Reliable Robotics are developing fully autonomous cargo planes that have already demonstrated successful test flights and are expected to enter service pretty soon. From there, it's only a matter of time before we start seeing regional jets and eventually even large commercial aircraft become pilotless. But getting the public wary of new software on commercial aircraft, thanks to the whole MCAS debacle, to accept self-flying planes might be the biggest challenge of all. So do you think autonomous planes could take off in the long run? And more importantly, would you fly on one? Let me know down in the comments below, and as always, if you found this video interesting, hit that subscribe button.